When you've prayed every prayer that you know how to pray.
There can be self-inflicted weakness. The ones you carry yourself to put it. There is no child that has fought with the father and fight with the mother and ever succeeded. You see, Galatians 6:1 says, children, and all of us are children. Children of God. Ephesians, sorry. Ephesians 6:1. Children, obey your parents in the Lord. See all of us here. Your parents in the Lord. Now who tell you? Glory me. Honor your biological father and mother. That is the first commandment with what? With promise. So that you may prosper and live long. So to live long depends on the honor you gave to your father, your mother, and your pastors, your elders, your leaders in church. Prosperity also depends on them. Otherwise, you can't succeed in life. You can't insult your pastor. You don't insult your father. You don't talk to your mother anyhow. Some of us have seen our mothers as witchcraft. And that is the same woman that affect you till you become old of this age. She did not kill you that time. Now you know God. So you don't open your eyes. Your mother now is rich. So that you don't take care of her again. You are a cursed person. You are a cursed person. Forget prayers. Who have settled with your mother? I am telling you the truth. If your mother is a witchcraft, the only way she will succeed to bring you down is when you fail to do your responsibility as a child. She will use that and pray. And then she gets you. Give her money. Let her carry that money to witchcraft. With an open mind that you gave that money as a child of God, she can't do you nothing. No weapon fashioned against you shall prosper. Any man that rises against you, don't judge. I'll show you something here in the Bible. Before we pray. Amen. Do you know God can also approve witness for someone? God give you witness. God can approve witness for you. And any time you pray for it, He will tell you, keep quiet. Allow it to be so. In other words, I use that your weakness to display my glory. There are some of us here, if God gives you the kind of miracle you are looking for, you won't come to church again. You know some of us, the reason why you are in this prayer is because of the witchcraft attack. That witchcraft is working for the glory of God. Open to Proverbs 16:4. Can somebody read? Put it on the screen for us. Can we read together? What to go? The Lord had made all things for Himself. Yea, even the wicked for the day of evil. He keep them to judgment the righteous. Are you with me? God keep them to judgment you. So sometimes, let me give you advice. Sometimes when you see some certain things happening, as a child of God, even despite the fact that you are praying, God may allow them so that you continue praying more. And the more you pray, you are closer to Him. So prayer draws you closer to God. Those problems you are going through, that witchcraft attack, is so that you start praying because you have stopped praying for some time. Now, once your faith is established, they will run from you because the Bible says, the Lord shall deliver a righteous man out of his trouble, and the wicked man will enter in his place. I don't know if you want to say, you know, you want to get in tongues. Because anything you lose focus as a child of God, God will not use a righteous man to punish you. He will use a wicked to deal with him. Am I communicating? But any day you return back to Him, you repent and return back to God, that man who has punished you will be there with two times. He will get double for that insult he has given to you. That's what happened to Nebuchadnezzar. That's what happened to the Egyptians. That is what is still going on today. That's what Simon says. Rejoice not over me, O my enemy. For when I fall, I will get up again. I'm the child of God. I will get up. So don't rejoice that I don't fall now. Because there's always hope of getting up. Simon!
Amen.
Are you a child of God?
Yes, sir.
There is hope of getting up.
Amen.
So whatever you're going through today, may be allowed for the purpose. That wicked man still tormenting you, maybe for the purpose. Once you realize who you are and return back to your duty post, they will be dealt with. And you can't see them again.
Amen.
Can I hear amen?
Amen.
How to deal with that your weakness? You need God. You need faith. We need faith. Luke chapter 7. I'll use two characters here to demonstrate something for us. Luke chapter 7. Are you there?
Yes, sir.
To verse 10. Talks about a man called a centurion. This centurion is like a captain in the army. And he was a very good man. He believes in the Jews and believes in Jesus. This man, because he believed in the Jews, had built a tabernacle, in a temple for the Jews. He loved the Jews. So they all the Jews, including the apostles, the scribes and the Pharisees, they know that this man, among others, loved them so much. So this man had a problem. One of his child was sick to death. And the man believed in Jesus. He sent his servant to go to the Jews. Tell the Jews to please tell Jesus to come to his house and pray for him. Pray for that child. When they came to Jesus, the Jews, the elders, told Jesus, this particular centurion is a good man. He had built the tabernacle for us. He loved the Jews. So we recommend that you should go to him. As soon as Jesus heard that, he made a U-turn to go. And while Jesus was going to the man's house, the man said his servant again, please, go tell Jesus that I believe him so much that I am not worthy for Jesus to come to my house. I'm a sinner. Just tell him that he is a man of authority, just as I am a man of authority. I said to this servant, move, and they move. This one, come, and they come. Let him just say a word. Let him just do what? Say a word. You know what Jesus said? Jesus didn't pray. He didn't say any word. Jesus just turned to the apostle, the disciple, and the Jews, and said, I have not found this kind of faith, not even in Israel. He just made that statement and turned back. He didn't go to the man's house again. The Bible says that as soon as Jesus opened his mouth and made that statement and turned back, the child turned up. Now I want to ask you a question. Is it Jesus' word or prayers that saved that child? Eh? What saved that child?
The
faith of centurion. He just believed in Jesus. Jesus didn't even say what. Just because the man believed, the miracle happened. If you believe, everything you look for in this prayer, you will get them.
Amen.
And you get even more.
Amen.
Psalm 3 times like Ponda. The next character I want to discuss is John the Baptist.